हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू अवर चैनल शिक्षक जंक्शन, क्योंकि अब नहीं तो कब। दिस इज आयुषी अग्रवाल एंड वी आर ऑन अवर लास्ट लेक्चर ऑफ द टॉपिक दैट वी हैव बीन कंटिन्यूइंग फ्रॉम सो लॉन्ग फॉर सो मेनी डेज, दैट वाज ह्यूमन रिप्रोडक्शन। लास्ट लेक्चर पे हम पहुंच चुके हैं और लास्ट लेक्चर जैसा कि आपको दिख रहा है, वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट ऑन दिस पार्ट्यूरेशन एंड द लैक्टेशन पार्ट। रेस्ट टिल एम्ब्रायोनिक डेवलपमेंट वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड, है ना। तो आई होप कि आपको कोई भी डाउट नहीं है, अगर है तो प्लीज डू आस्क इन द कॉमेंट सेक्शन और थ्रू द जीमेल आईडी। बट बिफोर दैट, द वेरी फर्स्ट थिंग दैट यू नीड टू डू इज सब्सक्राइब द चैनल इफ यू हैव नॉट डन सो फार, बट आई नो दैट यू पीपल हैव डन दैट, है ना। तभी आपके पास डेली नोटिफिकेशन जाते हैं और आप वीडियोज को वॉच कर पाते हैं टाइमली। चलो अब इस पर पार्ट्यूरेशन और लैक्टेशन के ऊपर बात करेंगे। फॉर दैट आई जस्ट remove this particular layer and yes, now we are going to study this particular diagram. देखो हमने क्या पढ़ा था अपने last के lectures में, we have studied till the embryonic development in detail, है ना। Up till the last month, that is up till the 9th month, we have talked about what happens or what are the developmental stages that actually takes place. Now the average duration of human pregnancy, okay, is, we all are very aware because we have learned that particular thing, is this 9 months, है ना। So this particular period during which the fetus remains within the mother's womb and it gets nourished through the maternal blood is known as the gestation period. An important, you can say, the name which you have to learn with respect to this is this gestation period. It is important. देखो नाम ही अलग आया है, बाकी तो आपको ये 9 months वाला पीरियड पहले से ही पता था। तो इसको हम क्या बोलते हैं, गेस्टेशन पीरियड। नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस इज ड्यूरिंग और आफ्टर द एम्ब्रियो हैज फुली डेवलप्ड, सी फ्रॉम द फिगर, दैट इज व्हाई आई हैव चूजन दिस फिगर, बिकॉज द एक्सप्लेनेशन इज वेरी एडमेंट इन द फिगर। सी, जस्ट हैव अ लुक एट द फिगर। सी, ओके, लेट मी चेंज द कलर ऑफ द मार्कर दैट आई यूजुअली डू इन ऑर्डर टू मेक यू एक्सप्लेन थिंग्स बेटर, है ना। अभी तक तो आपको भी पता चल गया होगा कि मैम कब मार्कर का कलर चेंज करती हैं जब वो फिगर एक्सप्लेन करती हैं। बहुत सारी चीज़ें फिगर से ही एक्सप्लेन कर देती हैं वो। देखो फिगर्स हमेशा से ही अच्छा मेथड रहा है याद कराने का और आपको ध्यान में भी रखने का, ठीक है। तो ये 9 month ओल्ड फीटस है, ओके, एंड वॉट इज देयर, दे हैव गिवन ऑल द ऑर्गन्स दैट आर द एक्चुअली द एक्सटर्नल ऑर्गन्स, है ना, यूरेथ्रा, सर्विक्स, वैगिना, यूरिनरी ब्लैडर एंड रेक्टम एंड प्यूबिक सिम्फिसिस। सो दिस ऑल इज देयर एंड दिस इज द प्लेसेंटा दैट वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट इन अवर लास्ट लेक्चर, ओके। सो वॉट हैपन्स इज एट द एंड ऑफ दिस gestation period, vigorous contractions of the uterus takes place and which leads to the process of childbirth which is known as parturition. I think I have given you a hint of this particular terminology in our last lecture. So what happens when it happens? Obviously when the fetus is developed at its fullest, then only vigorous contractions happens and it leads to the delivery of the baby out of the mother's body, and that process is known as parturition. But the main thing is, this parturition is not an easy phenomena that it is looking from this particular figure. Actually it is induced by what? It is induced by the complex neuroendocrine system. See, this is important. Our nervous system as well as our hormonal system act simultaneously, which leads to the delivery of the baby out of the body, and that is why it is termed as, it is governed by a complex neuroendocrine system. What happens is, the signals of this parturition originate from a fully developed fetus as well as the placenta. See, this placenta, I have told you, acts in as an endocrine hormone during the pregnancy as it secretes various hormones we have talked about in our last lecture. So what it does, it releases the signals or triggers the signals to this placenta as well as the fully developed fetus, and it leads to the mild contractions, and that process is known as fetal ejection reflex. Okay, you have to remember these terminologies, because when you are writing your exams and if the question comes, these terminologies becomes important. Okay, so this fetal ejection reflex is the mild contractions that are induced by the signals that are developed from the fully developed fetus and placenta. Now what happens is a very important hormone gets secreted. Again, I'll change the color and let you understand what actually it is. Okay, now a somewhat different color है ना, जो हम अभी तक use नहीं करा, शायद हमने अपने किसी भी उसमें उसको use करते हैं, देखो जरा. तो this fetal ejection reflex, after this fetal ejection reflex, what happens? It triggers the release of another hormone, that is oxytocin. This oxytocin is actually known as birth hormone because it is released only after the fetal ejection reflex, which in turn leads to the parturition process. So this oxytocin is released from where? It is released from the maternal pituitary. This also you have to keep in mind, that this particular hormone is released from the maternal pituitary, which acts on this uterine muscles or this urinary bladder and also obviously the uterus part. It is not mentioned here, but yes, it happens. See this uterus part. So this oxytocin induces the contractions upon strong contractions and relaxation on this uterine muscles, which in turn leads to the expulsion of the baby out. Actually, the first sign of birth, which you can see from the figure, is this ruptured amniotic sac. Okay, in the last lecture there was a diagram where the certain membranes were mentioned, and in that this amniotic membrane was also there, within which we have a fluid. What is the importance of that particular fluid? We will talk about when we will study about the reproductive health. Okay, but the first sign of a fully developed fetus that in turn is signaling to come out of the body is the ruptured amniotic sac. Okay, so after this oxytocin gets released and it leads to the strong contractions and relaxations on the walls of the uterus, which in turn leads to the expulsion of the baby out of the body, and this process is known as what? It is known as this parturition. Okay, now some other important chote-chote points are left. We will talk about those points also in detail here itself. Okay, so the important point which I was talking about was actually during this time. Okay, let me first clear this particular thing, whatever I have written. If you have any doubt, just don't hesitate to ask me. I'm repeating this point again and again so that you might not be able to carry your doubt. देखो मेरे को ज़्यादा मतलब obviously your mentor matters a lot when you are carrying your doubt, but it is not actually favorable for you, because if your doubts are carried or it gets piled up, the ultimate loss is to you. So do not afford your losses. Okay, I am there to help you with all your doubts, whatever you have. तो सबसे पहले जो हम देख रहे थे वो अपना हमने यहाँ तक देखा, ठीक है. इस फिगर में we have talked about the expulsion of the baby, or the baby emerges. Next, what happens is this placenta also comes out and then it is cut upon this umbilical cord. See the important thing which I have told you about the harvesting of the stem cells. If at all there is the parents opt for, then it is there and then it is cut out. Now another point which I was talking about was the differentiation in case of mammary gland. This also happens during the time of pregnancy. What happens is the mammary gland in the females, they differentiate, and by the end or with the parturition, this differentiation actually leads to the production of the milk. Okay, so this is the production of milk happens actually due to the differentiation of the cells that are there within the milk secreting cells. They start producing the milk by the end of the time, and this process is known as what? Another important terminology, that is known as the lactation. This lactation is important. Why? Because it is often suggested, not often, I should not use the word often, but yes, it is recommended by the doctors that the breastfeeding feeding to the babies is very helpful. Now, why it is helpful, that also you must know that. See, in the initial days of lactation, the milk that secretes out or that is produced is known as colostrum. Okay, this colostrum is very important for a newly born baby. Why? Because it contains very many important things that actually leads to the, or this colostrum contains several antibodies that are required by a developing fetus or that are required by a newly born baby in order to develop the immunity within his or her body. And this colostrum has a packet full of antibodies, you can say. So that is why the initial days of lactation is recommended by each and every doctor, and not only the initial part, but yes, there it is often said ki the breastfeeding is very beneficial to the baby because it leads to the nutrition also it leads, but yes, it contains several things that you can say that are required for the growth of a healthy baby. So this all also happens during the same time, during the time of the pregnancy or during the gestation period also you can say, because it is that particular time during which the baby gets matured into the womb. So this is all about the parturition and the lactation part. I hope ki everything is clear about that. If not, yes, I am there obviously to help you with whatever doubts you are having. Okay, most of the things I have tried to explain you through the diagrams, and I think that they are the best way. But yes, again, an important part, you cannot draw the diagram like this in your exams. You have to just listen and make notes. Okay, this is a very important point which you should keep in mind. If you are facing problem in making those notes, again, I am there to help you because I'll provide you with the notes, obviously the handwritten notes, but for that you have to mention your Gmail ID in the comment section. So do mention your Gmail ID for the notes. See, I'm writing this notes here very big so that you must have the remembering of this particular point. Okay, I'll provide you with that, but you have to send your Gmail ID or just mail me at the ID that is flashing on the screen right now. Okay, so rest all we will talk about another that the thing regarding the question answers part. As I have told you, we will discuss after the completion of reproductive health, so we will continue with the same. ठीक है, कोई भी डाउट आता है तो बहुत सारे मेथड्स मैंने आपको ऑलरेडी बता दिए हैं, आई विल नॉट रिपीट दैट. ओके, सो हैव अ गुड डे ऑल ऑफ यू, टेक केयर, बाय बाय, थैंक यू.